While we eagerly await Zack Snyder to release the Snyder Cut, I decided to take a look around and dig deep into the depths of the internet. So that landed me at the Nerdist. I wouldn't call myself a high-frequency visitor of this site. I was basically cruising for easy content, let's be honest. But I did come across a name that we all know and love, and this should generate great enthusiasm. Mr. Subvert Your Expectations himself has landed himself a TV show deal. It's coming from the Peacock, which is the NBC streaming service, and he's already received a 10-episode first season order. Of course, Rian Johnson is going to have to put that Star Wars trilogy on the back burner in order to make what he calls an update on the old Murder, She Wrote show of the 1980s. To quote Mr. Johnson, the man, the myth, the legend himself, he said, quote, "I'm very excited to dig into the type of fun, character-driven," character-driven in Rian Johnson, "case of the week, mystery goodness I grew up watching. It's my happy place." If you were wondering where Rian Johnson's happy place was, it was with Angela Lansbury in the 80s. To continue, having Natasha as a partner in crime is a dream, and we found the perfect home at Peacock, unquote. Now, of course, by referring to Natasha, he's referring to Natasha Lyon of the Russian Dolls show that was out. I believe it was on Netflix. And of course, that was the show directed by Harvey Weinstein's former personal assistant, who Kathleen Kennedy has brought on to do a Star Wars themed, if I remember right, it was a ninja martial arts alternate timeline Star Wars show for Disney Plus. You see how all this stuff is like bizarrely connected? It's like we need some type of X-Files map on the wall with red yarn and tacks showing all of the conspiracy of all of this. Now, this new Rian Johnson series will be called Poker Face. And as I mentioned, it's going to be getting 10 episodes out of the gate. Mr. Rian Johnson will serve as the creator, writer, and director of the series. He will also executive produce alongside his long producing partner, Ram Bergman. So this is Rian Johnson's first big push into television and streaming in particular. So the article I'm reading in The Nerdist says that they're giddy with anticipation. You know, I've felt butterflies in my stomach from Rian Johnson from The Last Jedi, but that was more like I'm going to be sick and I may need the world's largest pour of bourbon after watching. I mean, for real. What Rian Johnson did is I'll say it this way. He destroyed Star Wars. How's that? I'll leave the profanity for another time, maybe a live stream. Nah, I won't. Rian Johnson, you're a f***ing hack. And if you're listening to this with your round head and that big old pumpkin head smile, you can kiss my... All right, sorry about that. Let's get back to the article. Now, for those of you who care, and I'm not one of them, Rian Johnson's breakthrough film was a neo-noir movie called Brick. So apparently, according to The Nerdist, and who am I to argue, mystery stories are indeed his passion. Well, we all know he really sucks at science fiction. So we'll see what his batting average is with channeling Angela Lansbury in Murder, She Wrote. And of course, with the world being 2021 and the coof and all of that, there is no word when Poker Face will start shooting, let alone when those episodes will start dropping on Peacock. This clearly looks like that it is something in the, I would say, post-it note stage. Who knows when we're going to get this thing? You know what I'm curious about is why didn't Disney Plus pick up this brilliant crime show? Do you think it had something to do with the performance of The Last Jedi and how divided the fan base is? Or is that just me with a tinfoil hat? In any event, Rian Johnson, making his small screen debut with a Murder, She Wrote revamp for the 21st century called Poker Face. What do you think? Are you gonna TiVo or DVR or set your VHS VCR to record this Rian Johnson Mystery a Week? So believe it or not, that was actually my first Rian Johnson YouTube post. And I will put my stamp on it and call it good. I'm Corey B, and you have been listening to Salty Salish Sea. Have a good one. Hey, it really helps the channel if you give a like, subscribe, or comment below. I sure would appreciate it. Thanks.